Hi everyone. Today we're going to talk about identifying magnetite in polished section. So here we have our magnetite. It's gray with a slight brownish tint. And as we rotate this stage, you can see that there is no change in the color or brightness. So there's no bireflectance. Now if we switch over to cross polars and start rotating the stage, we can see that there's no change in brightness. There's just nothing really reflecting through or getting through anyway. So this means that it is not anisotropic or it's isotropic. Occasionally there might be slight anomalous anisotropism, but not the case in this sample. So that's the main things. It's not bireflectant, it's isotropic, and it's gray with a brownish tint. Now here we can see another one, and this is one that we've etched it with a iodic acid, and you can do this to highlight different orientations of the crystals. One orientation will dissolve more. And here we can also see the hardness difference, where our yellow chalcopyrite is much softer, and it's obviously lower in relief than the magnetite, which is higher. And we're going to put in cross polars, rotate again, and again we can see that it is not anisotropic, one of the characteristics of magnetite. One thing with the samples like these, where we have quite a bit of magnetite, you can also put a magnet on the polish mount itself, and it should attract the magnet. All right, we're going to look at our third one, and here's a cluster of magnetites. Again, it's hard, so it's in quite high relief. It's that kind of gray, sometimes slightly browner color. And again, it's not bireflected. And you can see again with the chalcopyrite, it's much more higher relief. One other thing with magnetite is commonly it can have exsolution of hematite, or sometimes ilmenite. Not the case in our samples today, but those things are, that you may see in the future. And again, we can see that it's isotropic. We have no change in color or brightness as we rotate the stage in cross polars.